This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Indiana Senate Bill 101, titled the Religious Freedom Restoration Act, is a law in the U.S. state of Indiana, which allows individuals and companies to assert that their exercise of religion has been, or is likely to be, substantially burdened as a defense in legal proceedings. The bill has been controversial. Opponents of the law claim that it is targeted against LGBT, lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender people and other groups. The bill is similar to the controversial Arizona SB 1062 vetoed by Governor Jan Brewer in 2014, which would have expanded Arizona's existing RFRA to include corporations. The bill was approved by a vote of 40-10, and on March 26, 2015, Indiana Governor Mike Pence signed SB 101 into law. The law's signing was met with widespread criticism by such organizations as the National Collegiate Athletic Association NCAA, Tim Cook, CEO of Apple Inc., Subaru of America, the gamer convention Gen Con, and the Disciples of Christ technology company Salesforce.com said it would halt its plans to expand in the state, as did Angie's List. Thousands protested against the policy, in part because of Indiana's reputation for Hoosier hospitality. Greg Ballard, the Republican mayor of Indianapolis, called on the legislature to repeal the law, or add explicit protections for sexual orientation and gender identity. Mike Pence has repeatedly defended the bill, stating that it is not about discrimination, including on an appearance on the ABC News program this week with George Stephanopoulos. An additional bill acting as an amendment intended to protect LGBT people was signed into law on April 2, 2015. Contents 1 Background 11 Burwell v. Hobby Lobby 2 Content 21 Signing 3 Impact 4 Reaction 41 Boycotts 42 Ending Boycotts 5 Further Legislation 6 Similar Bills in Other States 7 See Also 8 References 9 External Links Background. This article is part of a series about Mike Pence political ideology. Republican Party Vice President of the United States Elect Trump Pence Campaign Selection Convention Primaries Election 2016 Governor of Indiana 2012 Election Religious Freedom Restoration Act U.S. Representative Indiana's 2nd 2001-03 6th 2003-13 V.E. Indiana's Attorney General Greg Zoeller has written amicus briefs supporting same-sex marriage bans in Hollingsworth v. Perry and United States v. Windsor and appealed the Supreme Court's ruling on same-sex marriage in Indiana. PolitiFact reports that conservatives in Indiana and elsewhere see the Religious Freedom Restoration Act as a vehicle for fighting back against the legalization of same-sex marriage. In 2015, the Alabama Supreme Court ordered a halt to the issuing of same-sex marriage licenses, Kansas rescinded an LGBT anti-discrimination order, and Arkansas prohibited anti-discrimination codes being enacted by cities and local governments. Indiana, unlike neighboring Illinois, does not have a statewide anti-discrimination ordinance, and the majority of the state does not have local ordinances against discrimination against LGBT people. When a reporter asked Speaker of the House Brian Bosma whether it would be against the law for a business to put up a "No Gays Allowed" sign, he stated that it would depend on whether the business was in a community that had a human rights ordinance. In 2000, Pence stated Congress should oppose any effort to recognize homosexuals as a discrete and insular minority entitled to the protection of anti-discrimination laws similar to those extended to women and ethnic minorities. He called for an audit to ensure that federal dollars were no longer being given to organizations that celebrate and encourage the types of behaviors that facilitate the spreading of the HIV virus. He commented that homosexuals should not serve in the military, stating homosexuality is incompatible with military service because the presence of homosexuals in the ranks weakens unit cohesion, and in 2010 stated that repealing Don't Ask, Don't Tell would have an impact on unit cohesion. Pence opposed the 2009 Matthew Shepard Hate Crimes Act, stating that Obama would advance a radical social agenda, and said that pastors could be charged or be subject to intimidation for simply expressing a biblical worldview on the issue of homosexual behavior, Burwell v. Hobby Lobby. and other local municipalities within them. As a result, 21 states passed state RFRAs before 2014. In 2014, the United States Supreme Court handed down a landmark decision in Burwell v. Hobby Lobby Stores, Inc., recognizing a for-profit corporation's claim of religious belief. 19 members of Congress who signed the original RFRA stated in a submission to the Supreme Court that they could not have anticipated, and did not intend, such a broad and unprecedented expansion of RFRA. The members further stated that RFRA extended free exercise rights only to individuals and to religious, non-profit organizations. No Supreme Court precedent had extended free exercise rights to secular, for-profit corporations. Following this decision, many states have proposed expanding state RFRA laws to include for-profit corporations, including in Arizona, where SB 1062 was passed but was vetoed by Governor Jan Brewer in 2014. Content is signed into law. Indiana SB 101 stipulates that a governmental entity may not substantially burden a person's exercise of religion. One is in furtherance of a compelling governmental interest, and two is the least restrictive means of furthering that compelling governmental interest. The bill defines a person to include any individual, organization, or a partnership, a limited liability company, a corporation, a company, a firm, a society, a joint stock company, an unincorporated association, or another entity driven by religious belief that can sue and be sued, regardless of whether the entity is organized and operated for profit or non-profit purposes. A person, as defined by the bill, would be permitted to cite violation of this law as a defense in legal proceedings, while the bill explicitly states that no government entity need be involved in the legal proceeding to invoke such a defense. It also states that the governmental entity has an unconditional right to intervene in order to respond to the person's invocation of this chapter. Signing the bill was approved by a vote of 40-10. The governor signed the approved bill into law 3 days later, and the law became effective on July 1, 2015. Lobbyists from the American Family Association and the Indiana Family Institute, who pushed for a ban on same-sex marriage in Indiana, were among the guests invited to the bill's private signing. Micah Clark, executive director of the American Family Association of Indiana, previously stated that the organization would shift its focus from opposing gay marriages to preventing people from being forced to participate if they oppose them on religious grounds. Conservative Christian lobby group Advance America, which warned of dire consequences if same-sex marriage was enacted, stated on their website that the law means Christian bakers, florists, and photographers should not be punished for refusing to participate in a homosexual marriage. Governor Mike Pence has repeatedly stated the bill does not cause discrimination, stating in a release that the bill is about respecting and reassuring citizens that their religious freedoms are intact. Impact after the bill signing, a restaurant owner called Ryan called Indianapolis radio to say that his Christian belief in Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve, means he should be able to turn away same-sex couples within a week of the bill being signed into law. Memories Pizza, a family-owned business in Walkerton, became the first business to publicly announced that they would refuse to cater a same-sex wedding as a result of the law. The owners stated that if a gay couple or a couple belonging to another religion came into the restaurant to eat, they would never deny them service, they just don't agree with gay marriages. The announcement was followed by an onslaught of negative Yelp reviews for the restaurant, resulting in an average review of 1 out of 5 stars. Following the negativity, the business temporarily closed due to fake orders and threats it received. Due to this, supporters of the restaurant raised over $800,000 for it. Reaction. The Republican mayor of Indianapolis, Greg Ballard, issued a statement against the bill. I had hoped the state house wouldn't move in this direction on RFRA, but it seems as if the bill was a fait accompli from the beginning. I don't believe this legislation truly represents our state or our capital city. Indianapolis strives to be a welcoming place that attracts businesses, conventions, visitors and residents. We are a diverse city, and I want everyone who visits and lives in Indy to feel comfortable here. RFRA sends the wrong signal. Ballard called on the legislature to repeal the law, or add explicit protections for sexual orientation and gender identity, and has called for local human rights ordinances to be exempt from the statute. Ballard, along with 4 other living mayors of Indianapolis, Richard Lugar, William H. Hudnut III, Stephen Goldsmith and Bart Peterson, stated they are distressed and very concerned at the fallout of the bill. They were joined in denouncing the bill by Republican Mayor of Evansville Lloyd Winicky, who released a statement warning that this new law sends a message that contradicts what what I know to be true about the citizens of Evansville, we must continue to be a community of hospitality, warmth, and with a desire to treat everyone with respect. Mitch Daniels, the former governor of Indiana and president of Purdue University, stated that the university is opposed to any governmental measure that interferes with their anti-discrimination policy. James Danko, the president of Butler University, called the bill ill-conceived legislation at best, and commented, "No matter your opinion of the law, it is hard to argue with the fact it has done significant damage to our state." Michael McCrobbie, president of Indiana University, called on the government to reconsider this unnecessary legislation and stated, "The damage already done to Indiana's reputation is such that all public officials and public institutions in our state need to reaffirm our absolute commitment to the Hoosier values of fair treatment and non-discrimination." Charles L. Venable, CEO of the Indianapolis Museum of Art, stated the bill will make it harder for us to attract the best and the brightest to the state. 9 CEOs from Angie's List, Salesforce Marketing Cloud, Anthem Inc., Eli Lilly & Company, Cummins, Emmis Communications, Roche Diagnostics, Indiana University Health and Dow AgroSciences called on the Republican leadership to enact legislation to prevent discrimination based upon sexual orientation or gender identity. Tim Cook, CEO of Apple Inc., stated he was deeply disappointed in the law. PayPal co-founder Max Levchin told CNN opposing the law is a basic human decency issue, and stated, "I'm asking my fellow CEOs to look at how they're thinking about their relationship with the state and evaluate it in terms of the legislation that's getting signed into law." Yelp CEO Jeremy Stoppelman stated, "It's unconscionable to imagine that Yelp would create, maintain, or expand a significant business presence in any state that encouraged discrimination by businesses against our employees, or consumers at large." He stated, "These laws set a terrible precedent that will likely harm the broader economic health of the states where they have been adopted, the businesses currently operating in those states, and, most importantly, the consumers who could be victimized under these laws." Eli Lilly and Company stated that the outcome on this particular piece of legislation has been disappointing. Warren Buffett stated that if the law could in any way be prejudicial to gays or lesbians, I'd be opposed to that. The National Basketball Association NBA, the Women's National Basketball Association WNBA, the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever collectively put out a joint statement that read, "We will continue to ensure that all fans, players and employees feel welcome at all NBA and WNBA events in Indiana and elsewhere." USA Track. To drop Indiana as a venue for major events. Charles Barkley described the bill as unacceptable, and Jason Collins and Chris Clue opposed the bill. Arne Tellem stated that the bill codifies hatred under the smokescreen of freedom and jeopardizes all that has been recently accomplished, and called for sports organizers to re-evaluate their short- and long-term plans in the state. NASCAR stated, "We will not embrace nor participate in exclusion or intolerance." Gen Con has issued a statement that it will leave the state if the bill is passed. Eskenazi Health expressed concern that the legislation could lead to some patients being turned away from healthcare workers claiming religious objections, which would undermine our patients' trust in every member of Eskenazi Health's staff and our health system in general. On March 31, 2015, the Indianapolis Star published a front-page editorial titled "Fix This Now," which called for an offsetting law prohibiting discrimination based on gender or sexual orientation. The Islamic Society of North America expressed concern at the potential for the law to create employment discrimination against Muslims in a media release. ISNA stated that they welcome laws to protect an individual's right to free exercise of religion, but expressed serious concerns about the extension of those rights to corporations as well as the protections against civil liability for discrimination by protected corporations against individuals. They stated that, if a corporation refused to hire a person because they were a Muslim and their religious beliefs did not permit them to hire Muslims, then lawsuits alleging discrimination could not succeed because the law is a defense to liability. The Sikh Coalition, the Central Conference of American Rabbis and the Religious Action Center of Reform Judaism and the Disciples of Christ expressed concern about discrimination against religious and sexual minorities. Possible Republican presidential candidates Jeb Bush, Marco Rubio, Bobby Jindal, Rick Santorum, Ted Cruz and Ben Carson have all defended the law. Brian Fisher, the former director of issues analysis for the American Family Association and a supporter of the law, likened opponents of the law to Hitler. Micah Clark from the evangelical lobby group American Family Association stated that adding anti-discrimination language could totally destroy this bill. Former Republican Governor of California, Arnold Schwarzenegger, expressed his opposition to the bill, saying, "Distracting, divisive laws like the one Indiana passed aren't just bad for the country, they're also bad for our party." Jane Henniger, executive director of the American Civil Liberties Union of Indiana, stated that she was opposed to the bill. She claimed that SB 101 was too vague and could hurt the image of Indiana by perpetuating the idea that the people of Indiana could and would discriminate gender and sexual identities by masking them with religious beliefs. She makes a plea to the state that they should overturn the bill and listen to the many employers and activists that are against what the bill could do. In her statement, she also disregards the comparison of the RFRA of 1993 and SB 101 in response to the bill. Indianapolis resident Bill Levin founded the First Church of Cannabis, arguing that the bill now protected one's right to use cannabis for religious reasons. The church planned to test out the bill in full on July 1, 2015 by using cannabis during the service, but legal threats from the city forced the first service to be without cannabis several days later. The church filed a lawsuit against the city of Indianapolis and the state of Indiana, claiming discrimination under the law boycotts George Takei, actor and LGBTQ rights activist, called the bill bigotry, cloaked as religious protection, and called for a boycott of the state via his Facebook page and Twitter feed after the bill's signing on March 25, 2015. Using the popular hashtag #BoycottIndiana in an article on MSNBC, he recalls a similar bill in Arizona that was vetoed by Gov Jan Brewer and states, "The days are over where some may be denied a seat at the table simply because of who they are, or in this case, whom they love." Mark Benioff, CEO of Salesforce.com, described the bill as an outrage and announced that the company would cancel all programs that require customers or employees to travel to Indiana. Angie's List announced that they would cancel a $40 million expansion of their Indianapolis-based headquarters due to concerns over the law that would have moved 1,000 jobs into the state. The Disciples of Christ have threatened to move their annual conference out of Indiana over the bill. The American Federation of State, County and Municipal Employees announced they would pull their October conference out of Indianapolis. The band Wilco canceled a concert at the Old National Center, and Nick Offerman and Megan Mullally canceled a tour stop in Indiana. The mayors of San Francisco, Portland, Washington, D.C., Oakland, and Seattle have all banned city-funded travel to Indiana. The governors of Connecticut, Washington, Vermont, and New York State have all banned state-funded travel to Indiana, ending boycotts. The governor of Washington rescinded the state-funded travel ban on April 3, 2015. The governors of both New York State and Connecticut lifted the state-funded travel ban on April 5, 2015. The mayors of New York City, San Francisco, Seattle, Portland, and Oakland lifted their city-funded travel ban on April 7, 2015. Wilco's canceled show was eventually rescheduled. Further legislation: a bill intended to provide protections for LGBT customers, employees, and tenants was proposed by Senate President David C. Long and House Speaker Brian Bosma on April 2, 2015, and was subsequently passed by the legislature and signed by Governor Pence. The Indiana Chamber of Commerce, Indiana University, the NCAA, and Eli Lilly and Co. expressed a positive reaction to the changes. Greg Ballard endorsed the changes and suggested on CNN that Christian lobby groups like Advance America and the American Family Association are on the wrong side of history in this. Bill Osterl, the CEO of Angie's List, stated that he wants the state to implement a stronger statewide non-discrimination ordinance, calling the changes insufficient. Christian right lobbyists, who fought for the bill after the legalization of same-sex marriage, said that the changes destroyed the bill by preventing Christian bakers and florists from refusing service to same-sex weddings. Similar bills in other states. A study by the Associated Press and GFK of 1077 in April 2015 finds that 56% say that religious liberties are more important for the government to protect than the rights of gays and lesbians, but only 40% think most business owners should be allowed to refuse service to gays and lesbians on religious grounds. 60% of Southerners, but only 45% of Northeasterners or Westerners, say wedding-related gay-related businesses should be allowed to refuse service to gay couples. A similar bill in Georgia has stalled, with constituents expressing concern to Georgia lawmakers about the financial impacts of such a bill. A meeting on the bill was cancelled. Supporters of the bill have stated that the bill would be gutted by the inclusion of anti-discrimination clause. The convention industry in Georgia has stated that a $15 million business could be at risk of boycotts after the Burwell v. Hobby Lobby Stores, Inc. decision. The definition of religious beliefs has expanded from the beliefs of individual employees to the practices of closely held for-profit corporations. Georgia State Rep. Stacey Evans, Ars Marina, proposed an amendment to change references of persons to individuals, which would have eliminated corporations from the protection of the bill. State Rep. Barry Fleming, R. Harlem, noted that such a move would negate the closely held corporation protection granted last year by the U.S. Supreme Court in the Hobby Lobby case. The amendment was rejected on March 28, 2015. The Arkansas Senate passed a bill called the Conscience Protection Act, modeled after Indiana's RFRA. Hundreds of protesters rallied at Arkansas's Capitol to oppose the bill. Texas SJR 10 and HJR 55 plan to introduce a similar bill that changes the language from substantially burdened to burden. The Texas Business Association voted to oppose the bills. The Business Association argued that the state would lose events like Super Bowl 51, which will be held in Houston in 2017. Molly White introduced a bill that would expressly grant private businesses the right to refuse to provide goods or services to any person based on a sincerely held religious belief or on conscientious grounds. The bill was introduced following oral arguments during Obergefell v. Hodges. A similar bill in North Carolina has stalled, with commentators predicting a backlash similar to Indiana's. See also Arizona SB 1062, Kansas House Bill 2453, Sodomite Suppression Act. State Religious Freedom Restoration Acts. United States Religious Freedom Restoration Act. Houston, Texas. Proposition 1, 2015. Freedom of Religion in the United States Public Facilities Privacy and Security Act. References. Carrot. Indiana General Assembly. Indiana General Assembly, 2015 Session. iGangov. Retrieved March 29, 2015. Carrot. Indiana Gov. Pence defends religious objections law. This bill is not about discrimination. Newspaper The Chicago Tribune. Retrieved March 26, 2015. Carrot. Indiana not going to change anti-LGBT law. Gov. Mike Pence says. KTLA 5. March 29, 2015. Gays allowed sign would be legal in most of the state. The Raw Story. Carrot. State Religious Freedom Restoration Acts. National Conference of State Legislatures. 30 March 2015. Vetoes controversial bill, SB 1062. CNN. As quoted by ABC News This Week with George Stephanopoulos. March 29, 2015. Buckley, Madeline. 3 April 2015. Threat tied to RFRA prompt Indiana pizzeria to close its doors. Indy Star. Retrieved 3 April 2015. Star. March 31, 2015. March 28, 2015. Asks NFL, NCAA to boycott Indiana. Digital Journal. Carrot. Bradner, Eric. March 30, 2015. Republican 2016 hopefuls back Indiana's religious freedom law. CNN. Retrieved March 31, 2015. Blasting Indiana religious freedom law. KQED. Carrot. Connecticut to ban state-funded travel to Indiana over controversial law. Time Magazine. March 30, 2015. Sharp rightward turn. Convention industry says $15 million in business at risk. Atlanta Journal-Constitution blog. March 26, 2015. Carrot. Fight over religious objection proposals shifts to Arkansas. March 31, 2015.